that make you think about their presence.
And he drops in the layup. God, I still need to work on my defense.
And really, the scoring this quarter has been just off the charts, doing all he can to bring them back.
Just 1 second between the shot clock and game clock.
Oh, come on, Terrence. From Ross. Excuse me.
Here's Roberson. He's guarded by Ross. And there's the foul. It's on Steven Adams. That is his first foul of the game.
Second team foul. Substitution on the court.
And out of bounds is the Thunder.
Why? What are you guys doing? I did not tell him to pass it to him, and he goes and passes
Durant.
It to him anyway.
No good.
Durant, you still had enough time to get to mid-court and then shoot. You didn't have to just shoot it.
May be difficult to overcome. Welcome back. Fourth quarter action starting up in what has been a one-sided show. Thunder trailing by 16. Durant the three and Ibaka the four. Andre Roberson out there with Russell Westbrook. And it's Cantor in at the pivot spot, manning the middle. That's the lineup out there for the Thunder. Here's Durant. And no good. Trying to use the glass. And here we go with DeRozan running it up the middle.
Oh, my God. That's what happens when you try too hard
Durant
to do crazy dunks.
Right side Westbrook. Let's a floater go. The shot is off.
Not happening.
Now, Toronto takes it the other way. They led the game at 1 point by 20. They get to take on the Magic.
Oh, come on.
That is game three of this four-game trip.
No slowing him down. Just incredible numbers for DeRozan. 15 points, and from long range, he's hit 1 3-pointer.
And when it's all said and done, I got a sneaky suspicion he's going to have a few more.
Both free throws good from DeRozan.
Impeccable from the line since
okay.
No
switch to Corey
yet.
Joe. Look what happened.
Can't do much better than that.
I tried switching to Corey Joe, and it switched me like four other players right before that. Like, come on.
Allowing these easy baskets.
That's got to be job number one right now. Nothing easy on the inside. One made three for the game. Does he focus closer in? Let's see.
Roberson the pass to Westbrook, and Ibaka kicks to Durant. That three off the mark.
Hard to figure out how he doesn't knock that one down. No defender in sight.
Oh, Aaron Gordon.
And that's how the coach would draw it up on the fast break from start to finish.
Yeah, and what a finish it was, guys. Really nicely done.
And Westbrook, here we go. And he gets it to go.
Come on.
Westbrook's got 19 points.
Just good, aggressive drive from him that time. Found a hole in the D and went straight to the rim.
Pass to Valanciunas. Kicks it to Joseph. Outside DeRozan.
DeRozan three-pointer. Yes,
right,
hit that.
Target. DeRozan's got 5 points now in the quarter.
And he had one in the first as well. He can be dangerous.
LOL,
keep
dude walked right in.
And there's the call.
Oh, God, I shouldn't have done that. I'm an idiot.
Swoosh.
Give me a second. Back into it.
And we're around 2 minutes into the fourth quarter here.
Oh, wow.
And just a step ahead of the D in that possession there, making the pass nice assist.
Oh, my God.
Sends it back. Here's Roberson.
Oh, I just keep taking unnecessary fouls. Wow.
And the first one at the line is good. Damari Carroll's checked in for Joseph.
There we go. Carroll's back on.
And that's good as he hits both of his shots. Raptors leading by 15 to the right side.
Come on, bro, step up your defense.
And DeRozan kicks to Carroll.
I know. I'm not very good on defense. I need more practice.
On the wing, DeRozan. Good ball movement here by the Raptors. Five to shoot.
Oh.
Shoots it. Oh, yes.
And DeRozan still hits it. Oh.
DeRozan's got 7 points for the quarter.
And really, it looks like he may just try to take this thing over on his own and really build that lead up.
And Durant, here we
go.
I mean, he is tearing the defense apart. And let's face it, they have not brought their A game on that side of the ball.
Lowry kicks to DeRozan. Up top, Valanciunas.
Val. And he didn't Valanciunas cannot score unless he's in the paint. Okay. My defense needs to be a lot better.
Shaking his head. Tough miss.
What happened?
Clark. A look at the clock. A little under 3.5 minutes gone here in the fourth.
Really, Val, you can't catch that. Man's huge and then can't catch that.
Where that pass was going, that is a brutal turnover.
You have to like what you're seeing from Damari Carroll.
He's definitely rolling offensively. You might not be able to stop him, but you've got to find a way to contain him.
And let's get this update now from Doris Burke, who's across the way on the sideline.
All right, now I need to really pay attention to step in my game. It's not over. There's still a chance for OKC to come back.
Simply got to step up, get engaged, and try to battle back. Guys, we'll see if the pep talk gets them going.
Thanks a lot, Doris. Valanciunas passes to DeRozan. Lowry with the ball.
Kyle Lowry. Yes.
Lowry gets it to go.
Hit that three.
A 3-point barrage for them since halftime.
Not sure if it's been by design or simply by accident, but either way, it has been impressive.
And Cantor wide open. He shoots. Good.
Wow, my defense needs to be a lot better.
Westbrook's got his fourth assist in this one.
Yeah, and a big year for Enes Kanter last season. I mean, traded from the Jazz to the Thunder and finally saw the minutes that he was hoping for.
And the Thunder making a change here. Adams checked in. And here's Carroll. Hits it from 3-point range.
Yes, Damari Carroll hit that.
Carroll's got 26 points.
The D with very little pressure on their perimeter shooters. Three of the last five baskets they've allowed have been of the 3-point variety.
And you need the defense to stop the bleeding.
Again, Durant missing.
And he's really trying to get them back into it, but the results just have not been there.
DeRozan with it. Westbrook picks him up. Back to DeRozan. Out left to the wing. Valanciunas sets a screen for Carroll. To the middle. And that'll be Oklahoma City's ball.
Who was that for?
And so just rolling to the finish line.
Who's that pass for?
A very confident looking performance for Toronto.
It was like watching a 3-point shooting contest tonight here, Clark.
I call them warm up jump shots. I mean, three after three, it paid off for them in the end.
And it'll mark their fourth win on the year, actually, their fifth win on the year.
And with the win approaching, they'll take the first game here that they'll play against this team.
Oh, it's Patrick Patterson's getting some playing time.
And set the tone.
Even though I have no minutes for him, but he's getting playing time.
Conferences, and you can bet they'll take the same approach right into game two that they had tonight.
And what a huge standout performance it was for Carroll. He was doing everything right, and the points came in bunches. Definitely had the hot hand.
Stolen by Joseph.
Oh, here comes Patty P.
And it's Patterson finishing it off.
Well, if it wasn't out of reach, it is now, thanks to that last little spurt.
And why put the brakes on now? I just say keep on letting it fly.
Adams with it, working on Biombo. They get it back. Guys, we have seen them with a lot of good ball movement.
Well, you like the smooth operating they're showing you here. I mean, things are clicking, and more importantly,
yes,
it makes
foul.
To defend.
Clark, what you know about Sade? Smooth operator, but I agree with you. I think we're all seeing that right now.
Yes, indeed.
There's Foy with the three, but they recover it. Payne gets a wide open look. Gets the three-pointer to fall.
Can't just let them hit that.
Here's Patterson, and he's strong with the one-handed jam.
And really, no better feeling than to go on the road and play this well and get the win.
Yeah, it's always a good win when you play the kind of game they have played tonight. I mean, especially, though, when you get it done on the road. That's a special, special feeling there.
Probably going to take
a
shot.
Toronto takes this one, but by a big margin. This crowd was stunned by the manner in which their team was dismantled.
You know what? Shocking. I don't care what the matchup is. You never...
The 2K Sports postgame show.
Welcome back, everybody. Ernie Johnson here along with Shaq and the Jet as we present our Jordan player of the game, Damari Carroll. He's not always known to make the big headlines or get a lot of media attention, but he does make the big plays, and he made
yes,
them
Damari Carroll.
He was dead on from the field tonight, guys. I'd call
26
his performance
points, four assists,
because there was no wasted opportunities. He took advantage of every good look he got. I mean, everything he put up was going in.
Well, he showed us just how good he can be when he's at the top of his game. And the building was stunned. You saw people leaving early.
And that brings us to the end of our broadcast for this evening. For Kenny Smith, Shaquille O'Neal, Kevin Harlan, and our illustrious 2K Sports crew, this is Ernie Johnson saying good night. And we'll see you...
Kevin Durant with 25 points. Holy hell. Westbrook with 19. Carroll with 26. DeMar DeRozan with 22. Gordon with 8. T. Ross with 8. Kyle Lowry with 7. Patrick Patterson with 7. And he played like 2-3 minutes. He only played 2 minutes and he got 7 points. Wow. Norman Powell with 4. Oh, these poor guys. Poor Wright, James Johnson, and poor Bebe. They don't get to play. Not even in real life, they don't even get to play. Well, James Johnson does, to a certain extent. But poor Bebe. He's already 23, he's gonna be 24, and he doesn't get much playing time. He's good, though. Why does he keep hating me? The owner always hates me for everything I say. He wants everything to be about money and everything. Like, it's not always about that. You gotta have the fan base and everything, and then that brings in the money. Is there anybody I should pick up? I kind of like this team. Like, I'm not getting rid of DeRozan, Lowry, Valanciunas, Gordon, Joseph. I'll think about Carroll. I'm not getting rid of Ross. I'm not getting rid of. Bismack, I'd like to keep. Powell, I'd like to keep. Patrick Patterson, I'd like to keep. Bruno and Bebe, I'd like to keep. Wright, maybe. Jason Thompson, I wouldn't mind getting rid of. James Johnson, either. Gonna get the James Johnson. Why would I need another center? It's quite rude.